everybody, welcome to the Expresso, your daily shot of Chinese words with Catherine Xiang. Catherine Xiang, 大家好，欢迎来到我的频道 The Expresso。在这个频道，我们看字和词之间的关系。那么今天呢，我们是动物系列牛的最后一个小视频。Now we're finally to the third and final episode of the words with Chinese character 牛 ox or cow。那么今天呢，我想教大家三个俗语啊。So today I want to teach everybody three quite interesting expressions. 那么第一个是做牛做马，做牛做马。第二个是九牛二虎之力，九牛二虎之力。哦，废了九牛二虎之力，废了。九牛二虎之力。然后呢，第三个 ,the third one, that was inspired by another student made a comment of an expression he came across, and I thought, okay, let's include this. That is, 老牛吃嫩草。老牛吃嫩草。So, as usual, we will really looking at the word itself, how it's going to break down into different characters, what does that mean?And then we will look at how the characters are written in that particular expression. If it has historical record, I'm going to share where's the original source of that expression, where does that come from? And finally, we're going to look at how we can use these words nowadays. Okay, 那么让我们开始吧。So the first word we're going to learn is 做牛做马。做牛做马。Let's have a look together.第一个我们要看的是做牛做马，做 to be, so you will be 牛 ox, 做马 you will also be horse, you're gonna act as ox, act as horse. 那这个是什么意思呢？做牛做马。那我们看到我们的牛，牛是什么？一直在推车，推车。So you, the cow is always push, used to.Push the heavy stuff in the farm. 然后坐马呢？坐马是被人骑。While horses has always been ridden by people. 所以坐牛坐马。So if you will be the ox or if you're going to be the horse, then 辛苦的干活 you will work very hard.艰苦的生活 or your life will be quite tough because you work so hard. 所以做牛做马指辛苦的干活，艰苦的生活。我们会怎么用这个词语？第一个例子，只要加班费给的够多，我愿意做牛做马。只要加班费给的够多，我愿意做牛做马。只要 only, yeah?
加班费，加班费 extra pay over 加班 means to work overtime 费 fee so the overwork rate 给的够多，给的够多 enough being paid enough as long as the over hour rate is high enough 我愿意愿意 I'm happy to I'm willing to 做牛做马 work very hard OK 只要加班费给的够多我愿意做牛做马好第二个例子第二个这个是很有意思我们用来表示感谢 So you might not expect this We use this expression to indicate gratitude So the first one is more kind of a classic or ancient way of expressing You will hear this in a lot of historical TV soap operas So let's first see this one 唯有来世做牛做马报此大恩唯有来世做牛做马报此大恩 So only 来世 In next life 做牛做马 I'm willing to be You know cow and horse 报此大恩 In order to return your help 唯有来世做牛做马报此大恩 And nowadays you can make it more colloquial and you will say 下辈子 that's the same as 来世 next life 我一定 I'm definitely gonna 做牛做马报答你报答你 to pay you back so it's the same as 报此大恩下辈子我一定做牛做马报答你 so this is the expression typically we use it as a way toindicate gratitude and how you're gonna work if you don't have enough time to thank the other person you're gonna do that continue next in your next life and you will work as hard as ox and horse 做牛做马
so as you can see 做牛做马 is used to describe this person work very hard right so you could refer to yourselfI'm willing to do anything. I'm willing to be the horse, be the ox that I'm going to work very hard for you. Or you could describe someone else work very hard. 做牛做马 So this is the first expression we learned. Let's move on to the next one. 费了九牛二虎之力费了九牛二虎之力
我们要看的是这个成语是叫九牛二虎之力九牛二虎之力九 the number nine oxen or cows 二虎 two tigers 之 apostrophe s strength the strength of the power of so we have nine cows and two tigers strength combined那这个意思应该是很简单了对不对这个意思就是九头牛与两只虎的力气的相加 adds up of the strength of 九头牛啊，九头牛和两只虎两只虎那这个是什么意思呢比喻其力大不可挡比喻其力大不可挡 to describeThe power, the strength is huge. Yeah, you cannot handle against the strength. 哪里呢？这个是元 dynasty 啊，赵德辉三战吕布 is describing in a historical story of three fights against this guy called 吕布。So in the book, he talk about 兄弟，你不知他削肩点地，有九牛二虎之力，休要放他小些。兄弟，你不知他削肩点地，有九牛二虎之力，休要放他小些。So this is in classical Chinese. So 兄弟 like mate, referring to a friend. 你不知他削肩点地。So using the top of the shoe to touch the ground, so he can stand up on top of his shoe. 有九牛二虎之力。So he can basically weight his own body fully up. He has the strength as the nine cows and two tigers. 休要, so don't, please do not, 放他小些, allow him to rest. Allow him to rest a little bit. So this is the original source of 九牛二虎之力. How do we use it nowadays? This, typically, we will use it to indicate the effort that we put into. And the key word, the verb we will use is 费, to cost, to spend. 比方说,我费了九牛二虎之力,终于完成了这份报告。我费了九牛二虎之力,终于完成了这份报告。终于, finally, 完成了, completed, 这份报告。这份报告, this report. So I spent all the energy and so much effort. Finally, I've completed this report. 我费了九牛二虎之力,终于完成了这份报告。好,另外一个例子。他真是固执,我费了九牛二虎之力才把他说服。他真是固执。我费了九牛二虎之力才把他说服。固执 stubborn, 真是 really, she's really stubborn. 我费了九牛二虎之力。So again, I spent so much effort, right? I spent the power, the strength of 9,002 tigers. Only then 才把他怎么样说服 convinced. So I only just convinced her after all this effort.我们再来读一遍啊，他真是固执，我费了九牛二虎之力才把他说服。
Okay, welcome back. 九牛二虎之力, so nine cows, right, and two tigers. So we get the sense it's about, again, someone tried and made a lot of effort. So this is a useful expression to describe your effort when youachieve something or when you usually, you know, want to get maybe some compliment and or acknowledgement of your hard work, you will use this expression. 我可是费了九牛二虎之力啊。So this is 九牛二虎。Now finally, let's look at the third one, that is 老牛吃嫩草。老牛吃嫩草。
我们来看一下这个俗语的分解，老牛吃嫩草。那老就是 old, 对不对？牛我们知道是 ox or cattle, 吃 to eat, 嫩我们说很嫩啊， very tender, in referring to usually the meat, okay, or vegetable, 草 grass,老牛吃嫩草 ,old cattle eat tender grass, 这个是它字面的意思。那这个词语到底是什么意思呢？其实我们是、中国的农民，他们观察这个牛啊，年纪大的时候，牙口和肠胃系统都不好。So the farmers in China, in the village, they'll notice when the cow get older, 牙口 so their teeth 和肠胃系统。肠胃系统 digesting system become not good，所以呢，嫩草相对别的草来说比较嫩。So the tender, the young grass, right? Compared to others, they are relatively tender. So easier to bite, right? Easier to digest. 营养还比较丰富。Nutrition also very rich。所以老牛才喜欢吃嫩草。Therefore, they notice when cow getting older, 他们喜欢吃嫩草。那么现在指的是什么呢？后来泛指老少夫妻。So later on, it's used to describe couples who have very big age difference。现在我们是用来形容中老年人和年龄差异太大的异性结婚。或者保持暧昧关系，so it's describing elderly people either get married or maintain a relationship with people who are much younger or where they have a huge age difference，年龄差异太大。第一个例子，他与太太结婚时，很多人讲他是老牛吃嫩草。他与太太结婚时，很多人讲他是老牛吃嫩草。他与太太 wife 结婚 get married 时 when he was getting married with his wife， 很多人 many people 讲 in this case we can translate it as to comment。Talk about many people comment him was what 老牛吃嫩草，老牛吃嫩草。第二个，听说 Bill 正在和安约会，这是不是有点老牛吃嫩草？听说 Bill 正在和安约会，这是不是有点老牛吃嫩草？听说 I've heard 啊，听说正在 is something is happening。约会 dating. So I've heard Bill is dating Anne right now. 这是不是有点 isn't this a little bit 老牛吃嫩草 So this person imply the age gap is huge. So as we can see here, this expression typically referring to older men, but of course it can refer to older women as well. Both gender works. 好，最后一个。你不要老牛吃嫩草，他对你而言太年轻了。 你不要老牛吃嫩草，它对你而言太年轻了。So here we can say it's advice, 你不要 don't be 老牛吃嫩草，它对你而言，它对你而言。So for you, so she in terms of you, or 太年轻了 too young, so she's too young for you.他对你而言太年轻了。
Okay, I hope you now know the meaning of 老牛吃嫩草. Of course, it's used to describe a particular situation. If you use it to describe a person, it's not, as you can imagine, not the most polite. You're saying this person is too old, or you're saying the couple do not match very well. So I would say beQuite careful when you use this expression. But nonetheless, it is one part of our cultural expression, so it will be nice to know the meaning. At least next time when you come across this word, you understand what people intended to mean. Okay, 很好。So very well done today. This is the end of today's video. We've done three expressions, quite a lot. 做牛做马，做牛做马，费了九牛二虎之力。费了九牛二虎之力 and the last one, 老牛吃嫩草，老牛吃嫩草。So I hope you find today's content really interesting. We can see how Chinese people refer to animals. In today's video, we had the horse, we had the tiger, we had the cow, right? So, but all this is use animals to expressmeanings and emotion, and I think it's very interesting, and I hope you also find it interesting. Okay, stay tuned, and if you like today's video, please give me a like, it means a lot. Any comments and feedback, as usual, please let me know, and we're gonna move to the next animal on the zodiac. So, if you don't know which animal, please go find out, and I'll see you next time. 再见!